Yo, what's up, my crazy subscriber? This is Joking Johnson before, and today we're going to be talking about the highlights between the New York Giants versus the Houston Texans. This game happened on Sunday on the 9th, 21-2014. Now, I'm a big New York Giants fan. I've been a Giants fan since 2004. I've witnessed my team win Super Bowls in the HDTV, not like Dallas Cowboys. They're pretty much in the black and white era back in the 90s. So, yeah, and also I'm a big Cowboys trash talker, like fuck you Cowboys. Anyways, the New York Giants pretty much defeated the Houston Texans by a lot, 31-14, I believe. It was a big, huge lead, and the way it happened is just by the Houston Texans' mistake on offense. The defense was kind of alright, like it was kind of decent, but at the same time, they did allow a lot of rushing yards. I mean, Rashad Jennings from the New York Giants, the running back, ended up doing 176 yards. It's just really impressive against, you know, J.J. Watt, Brian Cushing, Marcellus, whatever his name is, Jadeveon Clowney. You know, all these guys, all these big superstars on defense on the Houston Texans, they didn't do crap against the New York Giants. I'm very surprised. The New York Giants right now are weak on offense. They're pretty much not showing any kind of, you know, life over there, but it's just that I know how Eli Manning is. He's just wishing for too many miracles this year. Like, last year he would like force the passes. This year he's wishing for miracles, because if y'all saw that last touchdown to the tight end on the left side of the goal line, he threw it like in the inside shoulder of the tight end, and there was a defensive back covering him. But the defensive back, the thing is that corner that was covering the tight end wasn't looking at the quarterback, so he has the back against the ball. And the way Eli Manning threw it to the tight end, it was just near impossible to catch. I believe that was like a 10% catch out of the 100. The rest of the other percentage could be intercepted or incomplete. So how the fuck did Eli Manning throw that pass? I'm very surprised. Go to the New York Giants highlight right now, guys, and watch that last touchdown that Eli Manning threw to that tight end. It was just incredible. It was just like, wow, that's a fucking miracle. I was wishing, you know, like, Eli, just make a better choices next time, because that's a very dangerous pass. I don't know how Eli Manning is surviving all this, but that's how my Giants are. You know, they're pretty much a big underdog. Rashad Jennings, another guy that pretty much set an example today. Rashad Jennings ran over 176 yards. I don't even know how he did it. They didn't show any kind of highlights on the his highlights on the video, full video highlights. And I still don't know how he did. I'm guessing he did a lot of, you know, running down the middle. Maybe he got like 10 yards each time and then go on to passing or something. I don't know what happened with Rashad Jennings. But if there's any highlights of Rashad Jennings going around, you know, let me know. I mean, I would like to see them. Another thing that happened is that a lot of the miscues in the first quarter and the second quarter from the New York Giants, they were pretty much preventable. I mean, come on, Zach Diossi oversnapping the field goal. Not oversnapping, like undersnapping. I mean, it cost the fumble. And it was just embarrassing. Like, what the fuck is going on with the New York Giants? Like, every time they start in the first half, it's like they're playing a college team, or sometime, like, I feel like they haven't played football in a long time. Like, come on, offseason's over. It's time to play the regular season, man. I don't know. The New York Giants is just, it's just quite a mess. But that's how my Giants are. I'm still a big fan, though. And, who else made an impression? That's about it. Only the Rashad Jennings. Eli Manning made an impression after that touchdown with the tight end. And another guy that's pretty much stepping up that I keep seeing is Corey Washington, number 88 from the New York Giants. That guy is a preseason sensation. He's been doing a hell of a job. Also, Odell Beckham Jr., he hasn't stepped into the field because Tom Coughlin wouldn't allow him. I'm guessing Tom Coughlin is like afraid for him to get injured for the whole season, because we all seen how David Wilson, you know, was. He was a first rounder and he couldn't just play straight at all like for the past 3 years, and he got career ending this year. So I feel bad for the guy. But anyways, the New York Giants won against the Houston Texans. It pretty much, Ryan Fitzpatrick did ruin the way the offense is in the Houston Texans. I feel bad for the Texans. They should have drafted Johnny Manziel. Johnny Manziel, I think he would have done plays for the Houston Texans, and I don't know, I believe he would have been greater than Ryan Fitzpatrick at this point. So, anyways, if you guys liked the review, please leave me a like. If you guys got any things to say between this game, the Houston Texans, and the New York Giants, please let me know in the comment section. I would like to see your argument on how the New York Giants still suck or the Houston Texans still suck, even though despite they're still 2-0. So right now, guys, the New York Giants won, and the Giants are currently one. No, they're currently 1-2, and the Texans are 2-1. Nobody goes undefeated. Nobody goes defeated for the whole season. So that's it for now, guys. Leave a like, leave a comment, tell me what's up, and tell me if you guys enjoyed this game.